Hey guys, Geek1 here, me guys in a review. Today, we're having a look at the Papo Spinosaurus figure. Now, I don't know about you guys, but I'm very, very excited for this figure. If you did not check out my unboxing video a week back ago, you guys know how excited I am for the Spinosaurus. I've been dying to grab my hands on this figure. And was it worth it? Well, we'll find out this review. Papo, if you guys are not familiar with Papo, is a French manufacturing company of animal figures such as like wild safari animals, marine reptiles, but they're most well known for their prehistoric animals. An example of that is dinosaurs. And this figure is absolutely fantastic. Love this figure. Now the figure is currently in this, I guess it's the shell. It comes in transit because the figure cannot stand properly on its own. And that is a big shame. It's not a fault with Papo. It's more of like the production, because there is knee warpage here. The foot is standing upward, and I tried the heating trick on it and it did not work, and I probably am going to destroy the plastic on the leg area here, so I just decided to stop. And I do have some support for this. I am in the middle of creating some support for it, so it will not be tumbling over and getting damaged. But for now, I have in this stupid little plastic tray. It's not really stupid, it does protect it though, but it does look very silly. Speaking of silly, I'm being silly. Let's get into this review. So let's pop it out of our tray here, and let's get a closer look at the details. And as you expect from Papo, you can just tell. I really don't even have to talk in this review. This is just an absolutely stunning piece. It speaks for itself, but the camera can focus. If the camera can focus, then you guys will see it. Absolutely fantastic. Now, I do notice that this Papo figure is very crocodile-esque. Spinosaurus was an aquatic animal, just like the crocodile or an alligator. And it does have some resemblance to an alligator, like the snout region here. The snout, just like the jaw, the scales, especially like the scales going around the neck here, all the way across the body. It looks fantastic. I would love to see an upscaled version of this from Sideshow, because this is an absolutely stunning piece. Even going to the bottom, you just look at the details. The sculpting work, very nicely done. Extremely done, actually, I should say. The sculpting of the tail going down here looks absolutely stunning. Got the sculpting lines going down there. I'm just gonna show you guys here. Absolutely fantastic. Very nicely done. See the wrinkles of the skin here. It reads like muscle, just the way this, like the arm is crunching backward. You see the folds of skin going there. Very nice sculpt work, and the detail is fantastic. Love it. You see inside, they got the membranes here. Let's go up and focus there. I need a camera if you guys cannot tell. The sculpting work here looks fantastic. It's like needle-like. Not even needle-like, just like some sculpt. This is fantastic. Ugh, can't get over this figure. The taste buds there look like taste buds. The tongue is sticking out there. It looks absolutely fantastic. Hell, even the roof of the jaw sculpted very nicely. I love that. Love that attention to detail that Papo has incorporated into this figure. They didn't really have to do it, to be honest with you. They didn't really have to, but this is exactly how I would have loved it to be like. This is fantastic. Museum quality and like mini sideshow quality. Now, in terms of the paint on this figure, it's not bland. As some people say, it is bland. In my opinion, no, it's not. You have some very nice mixtures of like purple, green, light green, yellow. Very nicely done in the spine area here. The spine itself looks absolutely fantastic. Yeah, like the different variations of black and shading scales, not just one flat black. All those different like crystal-like colors here. Crystal-like is the word I should have used. Very crystal-like. No, it's fantastic. Focus here, come on. It's amazing. Again, that head sculpt. Oh, just can't ignore the head sculpt. Papo, you have done a great job. Very nicely done. Absolutely fantastic. I haven't even gone with the claws yet. Well, there you go, guys. Let's get into a size comparison. Alright, for a size comparison, I do have the Papo brown standing T-Rex here. And I just want to show you guys a comparison of the scale work. So if you look at this Spinosaurus, like I said before, the scale work is very crocodile or alligator-esque. But if you look at this one, very lizard-esque. It's very, it looks very flat. And then if you look here, it's bumpy and, yeah, texture sound. You could hear. Smooth. This is very smooth and it's very rough. But anyways, it's a size comparison. Not distinguishing between texture. You can see here, they do scale up well. It does look actually really cool if you buy the collect a corpse here. And the Stegosaurus corpse figure. And just like, I'm gonna diorama Tyrannosaurus Rex like roaring from the distance. It's absolutely fantastic. And if you have the green Papo version, you get some awesome battle diorama poses. That how Jurassic Park 3 should have ended. So that looks fantastic. A little sauce comparison there. Absolutely stunning. Let's compare her to a smaller figure. Here is the Papo Ankylosaurus. And the Ankylosaurus is not a worthy opponent for the Spinosaurus here. See, Spinosaurus can just grab on the neck and just thrash this guy around. But you can get some nice poses here. So there. So that is very nicely done. And let's get another Papo figure, because I have a couple more in hand. Here's the Carnotaurus figure. Yeah, they don't look that great together, not for me. But see, there you go. Does look okay. And if you compare here, here's the Papo Allosaurus. So I guess these guys can go well together. Another great figure here. Check out my review a couple years back. This is another good figure. And let's compare her to a Hasbro figure, but this figure is not much of a blow. Here's the Indominus Rex from Hasbro. This is the Gyrosaur version. Check out my review on this one too. I appreciate it. These two sides up. I don't think the sides up very well in terms of height. In terms of length, still, I mean, this head is turned. Spinosaurus head wasn't turned, and they wouldn't go well in scale together, so I'd say no. They don't really scale that well. But can lift the legs up, and you can obviously fight. And obviously kill the Spinosaurus if you want. And last but certainly not least, and this is the figure I'm going to be putting in the diorama, here is the running green T-Rex. And these two, they size up very nice. Very nice together. Check out my review on this one too. And get some very nice poses here. Absolutely amazing. Probably my two favorite Papo figures here. Just love this green running T-Rex. Wish they could have released the brown version too. But yeah, absolutely amazing. Final verdict and final thoughts. So guys, I'm gonna be honest with you here. This is probably my favorite dinosaur in my collection. That is a figurine, of course. The Thrash T-Rex is by far my favorite. But in terms of a figurine, statuesque figure, the Spinosaurus from Papo wins. The detail is absolutely fantastic. The paintwork is great. The sculpt work is fantastic. Very nicely done. Everything is very nicely done, if you guys have not told. If you guys have not seen yet, I don't even have to explain to you guys how amazing this is. Because, hopefully the camera did justice figure. This is fantastic. Love the Spinosaurus. Don't buy the shitty Spinosaurus that Hasbro has offered you. Or, I mean, Hasbro has offered you for Jurassic World. Don't buy that Spinosaurus. It's crap. You'd rather pay $9.99 for a shitty figure that's like really dinky and small and has McDonald's quality, or would you rather buy a $25 set, nicely sculpted, painted figure like this? Bottom line is, guys, Papo, they deserve your money, because this is mind-blowing. You love dinosaurs, you're gonna love this. You love Jurassic Park, you're gonna love what Papo has to offer in terms of dinosaurs. And like I said, this is a 5 out of 5. Very nicely done figure. Highly recommend this figure. Very nicely done by Papo. So thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed this review. I tried my best to explain because I'm just gushing. I'm geeking out of how amazing this Papo Spinosaurus is. And I hope you did too, because this is a fantastic figure. So thank you guys for watching. Leave a like. Give this video a thumbs up. I'd appreciate it. Comment below. What do you think of the Spinosaurus from Jurassic Park? Do you like it or do you hate it? And what do you think of this figure? Comment below. Let me know. I'd appreciate it if you give this video a thumbs up. Favorite if you want. And I'd be highly grateful if you could subscribe. So thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. And take care, guys.